Welcome to round two, we're on the play once again. And I think we can't say no to that. We got a temple and a Tron piece and a map. Let me keep. So I'm gonna lead with Urza's mine. Map. Pass. Then we're in a temple. Reshaper, unless I draw a Tron piece. Because I drew a Tron piece, I think I'm just gonna get, just gonna finish my Tron here, and get. So that was the upside of playing, not playing temple. I think it would be interesting if I had like temple and Thought Nuts here in my hand. Then maybe I would want to play the temple in case I draw another one. I can turn to Thought Nuts here. But I think it was because it's so much more likely to draw a Tron piece. You want to start with a Tron piece. And just like turn three, Endbringer if you draw it. Playing it's blue white control. So we might run into mana leak. So I think I might just play Reshaper. Also, we're not really rushed if we're playing insta. If we're playing insta like a Jeskai control deck. So if I can play around mana leak, I will. All this dust. Yeah, I think there's no point in running Endbringer here. I'm just gonna Mana Reshaper, and then next turn I can play Temple and play around Endbringer, and play around Mana Leak by playing my Endbringer. I'm just gonna pass here. All right, Lightning Helix, and now we have Warping Whale, which is nice because we can Warping Whale end of turn, and if he doesn't kill the Scion, we can play Ulamog on my turn, which sounds great. So I'm gonna do that. Excuse me. Alright, you might try to kill it. Nope. Now it's interesting. Because we got map, we could get a Sanctum to, like, play Ulamog. Because you could still mana leak the Ulamog, obviously. But we exile two lands, so maybe that's good enough. Maybe not. Can also path the Ulamog. Yeah, I kind of want a map. Map for Sanctum, and then get a Kozilek. Sounds kind of cool. Yeah, I'll attack first, and then play Endbringer. Although I guess we have all this dust that triggers the Sanctum. Next story is gonna have Cryptic Command. Yeah, that's fine. So, Endbringer. 1, 2, 4, 5, 6. Map. If he mana leaks, we can sack the Scion. We'll attack with the Scion here. True Battle Skull. Yeah, I think we just jam Ulamog. Exile this and this. Crack Sanctum. Get the Kozilek. Sure. Can't. Sacred Foundry. We'll attack. I'm not even sure if I played a Kozilek here just because he can counter it with another mana leak. gonna like play Batter Skull. I guess I do draw cards with the Kozlik, like, and my deck has a lot of threats. You can have a mana leak. Yep. I was talking about threats. Well, this is one thing that we can't counter. We don't have a one mana card. Get a waste. Play a Thought Not Seer. Then we'll follow it up with probably Embringer or Smasher. I'll take Snapcaster. You have one Lightning Elix. I have 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 mana. So I can play Batterskull and Smasher. Sign me up. That's it. First sideboard. Against Jeskai, we're recommended to board in Relics, Needle, Aulis Dust, Karn for Dismember, Spellskite, Endbringer, and two Chalices. I'm not sure I agree with that, because I think that would be right if we were playing as Nahiri control, but I think because he's not, the Aulis Dust seems rather mediocre. And then if we do need them, then we'll have the Needles. And then worst case, the Needles can name Celestial Colonnade. So I think I will board in at least one Pithing Needle. We can keep like one Aulis Dust or something. I guess Aulis Dust could cover just about any, like you know, Alspeth, Sun's Champions, or a Jandy Vengeant, Gideon Jir, or whatever. And Dismember only really kills, like, it kills, like, Restoration Angel, Colonnade, and Snapcasters, but we already have, like, Ghost Guard just for the Colonnades and stuff. So I think I'm gonna follow what he says by board out these Dismembers for Aulis Dust, even though it's a little bit clunky. Word out true chalice is fine. Like, chalices stops Bolt, Path, Serum Visions, and on two Mana Leak, Snapcaster, Elixes, potentially like Reman or whatever. But those cards are not even that good against us. So I think two makes sense. And then Relic seems fine. Just a card that cycles and stops Snapcaster. Karn, just another grind card. Spellskite's not great. Warping Whale can counter like Crumble to Dust or something like that. So Spellskite stops like bolts and stuff, but all these cards are not even that good against us. So something like that. Warping Whale, yeah, counters a few things, ramps us. Yeah, I think that makes some amount of sense. So I kept an Endbringer over like a Pithing Needle that he was boarding in. If I see Nahiri, I'll board in the second Pithing Needle. Yep, this sounds great. I think I'm gonna get a second Temple to turn 3 Smasher or something like that. Although we have Karn, so getting Tron is somewhat valuable. I'm gonna play tower, play map, pass. this dust. Alright, try and assemble Tron, or trying to get another temple. I'm not sure what's more valuable. I think trying to turbo the Smasher is wrong, actually. You can easily deal with it, and it's gonna be more. It's gonna be a lot more punishing to not be able to assemble Tron here, because we do have a few cards that just can't really be cast with the temples. So I'm gonna go ahead and play temple, play relic. I'm not even gonna crack the map yet. I wanna see what other Tron piece I draw before I decide which one I get with my map. Plus, we're totally not in a rush. Guys, the Saint Draft. Well, that's one reason all this dust is great. We'll crack this just to draw a card. Okay, that's not the Tron piece we need. Thought Nuts here. We can cast Thought Nuts here. And we get another Geist or a path. We'll get a path. Alright. Worst case, he drew a bolt. Best case, he's just going to replay a Geist. Yep. And he drew a Ghost Quarter. He's probably going to. No, he doesn't. On my draw step, maybe. Sweet. Now we have access to Tron. So I have the choice between like not playing the power plant so that he goes for a temple. But I think it's unlikely. If he didn't do it now, he's probably not going to do it. So I'll play Power Plant and play a Smasher. And I can even cast my All This Dust with another Temple anyway. I think I just smash with both. If he attacks me back, I'm fairly happy about that. Because he's just going to be dead on this swing back. Okay, so he must have a removal or a blocker. If his blocker is Snapcaster, then we win. He drew mine. So it might be Cryptic, so I'm not going to cast something pre-combat. Cryptic. Okay. What? Okay. That's the only outcome that made sense. All right. Well, that was fairly easy. Yeah.